Hello again, and welcome back to Indianapolis for race two of round one of the GT20, or not GT24, it's not that anymore, is it? It is the Toro MSA GT Championship powered by GT Omega. Looking at Lobby B this time around, as once again, down at the bottom, you have the starting grid for the full field. Scrolling away.
That's a rather interesting break of an hour. Say what you like about Indianapolis. Nice dinners.
Nice lunches, for that matter. Here we are on the warm-up lap once again. Completely different view of cars that you're going to have for this race. Like we said, this is Lobby B as opposed to Lobby C that we had last time around. Even though that marked VDS4 does look very familiar.
You're looking at some familiar cars from GT24. There's the Weissman of DVD Magic Cap, rather. His teammate in the off number position behind him. There's the Ford, there's his teammate. As we see the Chevrolet just taking a wild slide on the warm-up lap. It's only the warm-up lap, and he's got his tires very, very warm indeed. Number 14.
Well, everybody has their own unique way of warming up their tires.
That was very unique. That was almost hyper-unique. Is that a word?
A much broader spectrum of cars in the field this time around. We have Weissman, Ford, Chevrolet, Lamborghini.
I just saw a Mustang as well.
Yes. I did say Ford now, didn't I? Yes.
You did say Ford.
Yes, I did. You have Lotai as well, or Lotus.
And this looks like a much better Rover instead. As you see, Lobby C was full of the less competitive drivers. Possibly didn't know what they were doing. These guys certainly do know what they're doing, as we see a very well-mannered line up before they even get to the final turn.
Yep, we don't have a case of the spread outs here. They're not playing Three Stooges. Let's see, we are coming into the final corner here.
Not playing Three Stooges. Look at this. This is Running Man. What's Magic Cap doing?
Well, they pass the start or the pit entry lane, which is plenty of time to say go, which is what they have done.
That's
and
more
a
like
much,
it.
Much better, much more exciting start as we have an onboard with Blizzard here. Ooh, but lots of tires squealing, but Blizzard getting a heck of a start here.
Oh, that's the Ford from the front row. It's selective row. What a mistake to make. And he's lost everything in that first turn. But tell you what, comparing these to the GT24 starts, that's the best one I've seen them do so far. Well, since
a little bit of nerfing action there, possibly.
Seen more of it already, yes.
This is Exiled in a Corvette trying to fend off from Blizzard in the Aston Martin. Oh my, this is a much more exciting race already.
We have a big comparison to the C Lobby. We saw how, well, I don't know if you noticed it, but how slow they were in these corners compared to this stop. Oh, these guys
did
are...
Did I just see Blizzard fly off to the side there? Yes, I did.
See McLaren off as well, and we see the Ford cut in. Oh, naughty boy.
He was ran down there, I believe, by
and
Blizzard.
Gundam used to drive the black Nissan Skyline, remember? Yep, number 19, it's Gundam. He's trying to gun down an Aston in front of him. There's a replay.
Replay of the start here. What are we going to see? Duncan gets a... Oh! I think he had a bit of contact there.
Yes.
And yes, he did have a little bit of help there from Arrow.
That's Arrow. The wise guys looking so foolish.
Arrow wasn't happy with how he shoved him out there. Just that nerfed him.
See another one. Very good how did that helicopter get so low? Tell you what. Wouldn't surprise me if there's a penalty involved.
Check the, that was a very hard impact there.
Braking area, brace yourself as tap. Oh.
Curious to know how badly that Weissman was injured of Arrows there after that accident there.
This is a big mix. We've got a Goliath of a Ford and a... Let's just say, David, in comparison, there's the plucky Lotus, the teammate of the guy in Lobby C earlier.
So the AR coming through turn six is... Ooh, Gundam stuffing it up underneath Arrow there. Didn't work, though.
Such a move, Jake. That Lotus and GLR shooter. Very hard work to get through the entry list for this. That's what he said in the first race. More than 45 entrants made their way to Indianapolis, as we still see the battle for the midfield, essentially. This is Lobby B, as we see the Corvette, a DB, one of the, well, a number DB, I'm guessing, at least. And Weissman there, Mustang, Lotus of GLR Shooter. We've got to it eventually. We complete the second lap of the race.
Right, you keep mentioning more than 45 cars in this race. That is simply because this is not what we've ever had for a Toro sanction event. Ooh, I think Errol grazed the wall coming out of turn one there.
Do not want to do that to a Weissman. Complete wall, please.
You do not want to do that to any car. That will ruin your race in a big hurry and possibly anybody behind you.
Gundam looking. He's
going to try the seesaw on him. I don't think he's going to get it, though.
Such a wide entry to the first turn, but then it's such a narrow exit. You see such. There's the Lotus having a fight.
Tap from a Lotus.
He's fighting people, not his own size.
That Mustang does look big and bulky. He looks like a little bully picking on all the little tiny guys with the little tiny European card.
Lotus suffered from short man syndrome, of course. Anyway. Yeah.
Napoleon Bonaparte syndrome. You can't forget it.
See the Weissman there? That looks like damage. It's actually an air vent. I've been confused for that before in GT24s. That Weissman has got two rather sort of subtle air vents that look like there's been damaged because it did hit that concrete wall, and we did hear it quite hard.
Alright, now it's three-way battle here for what is third in the lobby. Gundam hounding Arrow here in the Weissman. Have we had a change up at the front? I think Magic Tap has fallen down to second.
Is that Lotus attached to that Mustang?
Might as well be, I tell you that much.
He's not going to get it there.
The Velcro that came off there.
Gundam
well. With the track boundaries there.
Can't believe the range, the vast array of racing lines that people are doing. There's a long string of cars now. We're looking at second in the lobby, back down to possibly eighth. They're not that close, but you can see, look at it. We've got about five or six cars within the same shot. As Gundam takes a chunk out of that line.
So the Lotus all over the backside of Gundam still. And with all these cars battling it out, you got to keep an eye on those two. That's a Lamborghini and a Ferrari back there. Yeah, that Ferrari's painted up, looked like a Gallardo once again.
Tricks of the trade and trying to disguise your car to make it look like another one. Have you seen the Lotus nibbling back of its elders, essentially, as the Mustang? Not enough speed to get one back on that Mustang. Still crunching against the concrete. He's late enough to take it, though.
No, definitely don't think so, as that Mustang's got some grunt going down the front straightaway as he airs it out. As we come back onto the front battle here.
Corvette in its natural habitat. Now taking their natural habitat of like two.
It's a GT1 battle all over again from years past with Corvette versus Aston Martin.
Bear in mind, we'll have to rummage through the entrance here. Number 14, where is he?
So down on the back straightaway go, see if this Aston Martin can do anything with this Corvette.
Is he still warming up his tires? He's hope not. Smooth as you can be through the sweepers. Take as little as you can out of the right angle once again. We've seen them try to cut that corner as much as they can. They're going to get caught for it though. Back onto the oval. Back onto the speedway section. And that's Exiled.
It'll be interesting if Blizzard can catch up anyone Exiled here in this vet down the straightaway. I'm not quite sure which one of these cars has more grunt down the straightaway, as we haven't really had a... drag race process.
I think the Corvette's just edged it.
No, But the Aston's got very good superior brakes there that you can see, and he closes up that gap a whole lot underneath braking here.
I was right, haha, they were both flanged.
No, that is Ferrari and a Lambo.
Oh!
So we have Audi Sport Louis in the Lambo trying to pass a Ferrari here, and he's going to do so successfully.
Punished for looking like a Lambo.
See if the Ferrari's got anything here for Louis. Back straight away they come once again. Doesn't look like the Ferrari's got anything here at the moment.
Quite close. No mistakes from this pack. Behaving themselves through that right angle. And Duncan's catching up after that. Selective Rogue's catching up after that spin. I hear the marvellous roar of that Lambo engine. Here we go.
More of a roar compared to the hum that comes out of the Ferrari as we see Selective Rogue closing in on Spartan here.
He's having a bit of a fight back after that mistake. He did get hit in the first turn. I think he's after revenge.
Doing a swell job coming back up through the field, that is for sure.
You see the various lines of the cars taking that bottleneck in the first turn.
Tell you what, Selective Rogue just pounds the curbs coming into the infield, doesn't he?
As a man on a mission, a collision at turn one. We've got a lesser spotted Maserati Gran Turismo. We didn't see it in GT24. It was on the, I think it was on the allowed car list. And you managed to make its way into the GT series. Quite welcome addition. All cards are welcome, essentially.
Might as well all be welcome as we're seeing a great battle here, as there was only two cars between Audi Sport Lewis
and they're all different
Ferrari.
As well. They're sitting with, well, the Lambo that looks like a Ferrari, or the other way around, and then there's the Lambo. There's the Aston, which Selective Rogue is chasing. He's got the move. The mistake was made coming out of the final infield corner.
Well, he's not chasing anymore. He's now leading that Aston Martin as he's going to set his eyes on the two Italian cars right ahead.
And there's flinchy smoke. There's evidence of a tussle going on. Evidence of a tussle. Yeah, look at that.
Oh, look at that. Rogue got a run spark right down to the pit wall. I think the Aston Martin's going to get through here once again.
Breaking area, brace yourself.
Very nice.
And that Maserati's not, he's keeping close attention on this. You see five different marks battling for position. We're just hearing the magic tap in the Weissman is having electrical issues. We're hearing from the pits that something has sort of switched itself off, but he is losing the lead. We're not, because we're looking at a rather good battle. Might be a battle for six different marks. Having a battle of this magnitude.
We've got to wait. And
oh, it's another
lap. Has switched it over to reserve now and has now gotten back under power from what we can hear.
Right, it's lost the lead. I just seen it going under the window there. It's just lost the lead.
Come on, Mr. Producer, give us the front battle. Let's see if there's going to be one there.
That's exiled in the Corvette now, isn't it? We didn't see him having a battle with getting third place, but exiled is now in the lead. Maybe Magic Tap's going to lose second as well.
We have to wait and see. We got a cracking battle right now going on, though.
Appears no moves being made.
He's lost a bit of ground there to Exiled in the Aston, hasn't he?
Now's your chance, Director. Now's your chance. There's not much going on.
Well, you definitely closed it up with a perfect entry into the infield.
I think we're seeing the sort of accordion effect. We see the faster guys spread out. And when it comes to these sort of corners, The guys that have got the handling right in these cars, it could be any of them. Obviously the better handling ones, but then anyone's got... Ooh, a clip going on there. There's a Lambo hitting into that Maserati.
And yes, this is the front once again. This is what we were asking for. Exile has gotten around Magic Tap indeed.
It looks like Tap's got it back again. Whatever that electric collision, it's been fixed. And we could be seeing a battle. We could be seeing the lead getting back because Tap is good.
Gotta love the reserve switch on these things.
Control Alt Delete always works. It's from the outside going to the braking area for turn one.
Try the outside. That is the long way to go, but I've seen it done before. Oh, not happening this time.
He bowed out that one. I think he was clever enough to do that because it's such a bottleneck. The first turn wide enough, but then you've got such a bottleneck of the little stretch of straight line that you don't really see there. Going into turn two, he didn't want to pull that move off in case there was a collision.
Oh, but he tries it. A little bit of contact there.
I don't think there's any contact at all there. I think Exile was quick enough to notice that Tap was going to make the move, but obviously he's defending that one as well as he can without hitting him.
I would have been absolutely impressed if Magic Tap pulled that one off, because that is literally impossible to pass down there. Magic Tap is all over the back of the Corvette.
Seeing that Tap's teammate, in fact the team leader of PTR, Aerodynamics, Aero in fourth, and then we've got Shooter in fifth. And I believe that we're not seeing it because we're still looking at the leader. He's managed to have. Oh no, I was going to say he's fended off the battle for the lead. He's got another fight coming on here. Taps, not letting this one go.
Oh, there's contact!
Oh!
Magic ran right into the backside of the Corvette there.
I can't believe he did that. I really can't believe he did that.
Oh no, I think he just ran off Blizzard in the Aston.
It was going so well. Look at that. It was so well mapped. I mean, the fight was going on, everyone was well mannered, and it's just like a Jenga. Everything's falling apart here. I don't know who's in the lead.
I'll have to wait and see, but that was unbelievable. I've never seen Magic do a mistake like that, for sure.
Exile's still got the lead there. Exile's still got the lead.
Yeah, that's the top
this
five right
second.
There.
Well
done by the Corvette. But...
Wow. We've seen the Lotus of Shooter. We've seen... Oh. I can't end this. You just talk, I'll just watch and just...
This is madness, shout. That's all it is. That's all we need to know, is madness.
Oh, we got another one! Another collision! What is Tap doing?
Was there a collision back there?
I
believe that's Aero, not Magic Tap.
There was three cars trying to get into the same space, and... It was Aero. It was Aero. It's a descendant.
It's a big mistake there. Both cars look exactly the same.
All that descends into anarchy as we get into the last five laps.
Oh my goodness, as here comes Blizzard making
Breaking
a pass.
Area. Brace yourself, as you see Blizzard's taking the lead, and we've got Shooter's got it in second. Before this chaos. My god, what the hell's going on?
And they're still going all over the place. The top six are right here, all in one spot. Oh, this is what we were lacking in race one, and obviously, this is it. And oh, there was contact there. Magic trying underneath turn six. Oh, more contact.
Oh, no, no.
Hold on to it, son.
I don't know if they're trying to look for revenge for hitting each other earlier, but Exile's lost the lead. Tap's lost the lead after trying to go for it. We've got Shoot there who was just hanging in there, waiting for something to happen. It's happened, and now he's got the lead. He's got Aero all over him, though.
That's Blizzard up front, not Shooter.
Sorry.
Shooter's in third in the Lotus.
Shooter in third.
That's right, Adrian. There's so much
going on.
He's
gained the most. He's gained the most. I can't believe in a track which depends upon their speed, there's only one or two slow corners. We've got a Lotus in third. It's because of all this infighting. that the Lotus is in third, and it's an unbelievable run, and I don't think it's going to stop for the last four laps.
Definitely don't think so. As Matt, oh gosh, this is deja vu all over again, only with everybody in front of him.
It's the anagram of deja vu because they're not in the lead anymore. Braking area braces up. Schumer's in second. What's going on?
That happened right in front of me and I didn't even notice it.
With the Mustang, I think Tap's gone. Tap's gone again. Something must have happened with Tap.
I believe it's damage, and I think he's actually, he's not there. He pulled it off at the end of the lap there.
Whatever happened earlier has finally caught up with him. They tried to rectify it. Yeah, he's in the pits. He's not looking happy.
As you can see, he slams the door and throws his helmet across the pit lane there. Well,
they're not focusing on it. You're missing.
Can't see it, but we can now, obviously. Such a shame here, but anyway, we have a battle for the lead here in the lobby with when they cross the line, three laps to go. Adrian, I know you've been holding your breath for a while, but you got three more laps more to do it.
I've got nothing left. Where are my lungs? I think everyone's calmed down.
Which makes smoking look healthy at this point, doesn't it?
Yeah, what's happened is the problem that Tap, because he just held on to that lead so long. The problem that Tap had caused just this wave of chaos to happen, and I think everyone's settling down now, because I don't believe that Lotus is not quick
Ooh,
enough.
Blizzard out breaking himself a little bit going into turn one. Yes, he did lose the spot. We have a Lotus in the lead at Lobby B. Track that is not suited for that car, and it is leading the lobby. I don't believe it.
I'm sorry. Just forget everything. I'm no longer an expert. I never was one. Right?
You're the unofficial selection. Yes.
The race is going to calm down from this point. The Lotus wasn't going to get into the lead. What's happened? The exact opposite. So we've got the Aston in second.
About to have an Aston in third as here comes everyone to Weissman, and he is going to take second, I believe.
There was a collision between the Aston and the Weissman, and the Lotus is just.
Drivers will carry on as we have a great battle here between. Ex teammates here back in the ISCC, back when it was the Le Mans Series Championship. Audi Sport, Louis, and Selective Rogue. We've seen a few of these battles before.
We're expecting Rogue to be causing most of the sort of revenge, but he's not even close to the pack at the front. I think, is this the battle for sixth? Because Louis, Duncan.
I believe it is now the battle for sixth, as Louis is going to go ahead and take the defensive line immediately down the front straight.
It's right? A fine time to sort of divert away from the pack of five at the front to focus on something.
Maybe something that's not as stressful.
Yeah, certainly calmed me down. certainly disappointment is a calmer to. Anyway, we're seeing Audi Sport fending off his former teammate in another series. And there's the Vitaphone Aston. And I think that's the Lambo looking Ferrari, if we can get these right.
Spartan. Look at the torque of the Ford and the Lambo holding it off.
If there's going to be a move here, it's not going to pay off because those two turns, not exactly braking areas, not exactly places you're going to get past, nor is it by here that right angle. It's just momentum curves and then get that last one right before getting back onto the oval.
You gotta get your momentum right and get a right run off that corner to get it off. And by the looks of it, Louis in that Lambo has definitely gotten the run out of that corner right because he has aired it out over that Ford of Selective Rogue. Big time, look at the gap.
The wall. It looks like we've been close to it a number of occasions. We've only heard the crunch twice.
Final lap, Adrian, hold your breath.
We can see the pack just sort of escaping camera shot there. We still see this half battle in comparison to the chaos that happened earlier. Shooter is still in the lead. I can't believe we're not focusing on that, because this is a true underdog race. If a Lotus Evora compared to the beasts that encompass the GT field, especially on the track that's not suited for it.
Well, every dog has its day, as does an underdog. As here we are through the S's for the final time.
Woof, woof.
He's got quite a decent lead there. I don't think the Aston's going to be able to drag it coming onto the front straightaway here.
I can't believe it. Nobody's caught up, because I was expecting this car to hold everyone up. When everything, all that's happened is that everyone has just sort of been fighting with each other. And this driver's been clever enough and smart enough to take the flag in race two of Toro's GT series.
Very nice.
And that's for Lobby B. It's for Lobby A. FOH Mofar again, the front runner from FOH Carrera in second. ATR Dan, followed by Ian Ma, Candyman Cody, GLR Insanity, FOH Bullet, Plough Run Wide, GLR Gassi, and GLR Mickham. As for Lobby B, which you've just witnessed, Shooter, unbelievably, in that Lotus Evora, followed by Blizzard in second place, and Izzy Gundam in third. As for Lobby C, you saw General So win race one in Lobby C. He also won race two in Lobby C, followed by Frankie Fan in second and the Shattered Soul in third. This has been the Toro GT Championship powered by GT Omega. I've been Adrian Michael Reese, Louis Sattley on the commentary, directed by Simon Biggs.